This is the lovely star of Hollywood and television, Alan Ludden's beautiful wife, Betty White.
Thank you. And this is my partner, Robert Ware, from Indianapolis, Indiana.
This is the celebrated humorist and television star, Miriam Parr's wonderful husband, Jack Parr.
Hello, this is my partner, Anna Zarelli, from Staten Island, New York, and we're all here to play Password.
Yes, it's Password.
Password, the original daytime game show. Airing for 6 years in the 1960s before being revived a few times, the show is a staple in the history books of game shows. The show premiered on October 2nd, 1961 on CBS in the 2 p.m. slot, replacing the series Face the Facts. As it became the first of many popular civilian celebrity team games, the show became an instant hit for the network, as many other networks tried and tried again to create similar shows to take it down. A couple years later in 1966, ABC launched the Newlywed Game. We've all heard of it. That swayed viewers from Password, causing it to drip. Also allowing NBC's Days of Our Lives to bump up in their time slot. That led CBS's executive head, Fred Silverman, to cancel the show. He personally wasn't a fan of the game show genre. And then you add to the fact that they had no idea where they were going to host the next season. They wanted it to be filmed in New York, Hollywood. They couldn't really get together on it. And it was at the turn of where black and white television was also turning into color television. So at the end of the day, they just ended up canceling it. In the early 1970s, ABC decided to revive the show after syndicated reruns became popular in various markets around the country, appearing most in the mid-morning slot or the late afternoon slot. So either your 10 a.m. slot for your mornings or your 2 to 3 slot for your mid-afternoons. ABC would premiere the program in the 12:30 spot on September 6, 1971, and it was rough. After 6 months, the show would drop down to the noon slot and would come in second to Jeopardy until The Young and the Restless premiered in the summer of 1973. The show would then struggle for the next couple years as ABC tried many gimmicks to try to attract viewers, but they failed and the show was canceled.
It's more than Password, it's Password Plus.
Now, only a few years after that, NBC would pick up the format for the first of three reincarnations with Password Plus. That ran from 1972 to 1982. That was then followed by Super Password from 1984 to 1989. And then Million Dollar Password that ran from 2008 to 2009.
The greatest comedy actresses of all time. She's a Password legend. Betty White, everybody. What a job. Everybody loves Betty White.
Alan Ludden was the host of the first 20 years of the show until his death near the end of Password Plus in 1981. He was then followed by a period of short-lived replacements up until the end of Super Password, and Regis Philbin was the host of Million Dollar Password. But let's get into the gameplay. You've been waiting some time for this. The game is very simple. You've maybe played a few kind of games now at some parties that are very similar to how the game was actually played and now are now based off of. In each episode, there were two teams made up of one celebrity and one civilian. The host would then give either the celebrity or the civilian contestant a card with a password on it. Now, the password was a word that one teammate would have to describe to the other contestant one word at a time. Once a description of the word was said, the other teammate would get a few seconds to guess the word before it jumped over to the other team for their chance to guess the word. And it continued back and forth until one of the teams was able to decipher the clues to guess the word. Now, the teams were not allowed to say more than one word at a time. See, any hyphenated words, made up words, or slang. But you can also not say part of the word. If you're thinking about saying password, you can't say pass, or you can't say word in your clue. Now, if they violated this rule, the buzzer would go off and they would give the other teams the points. Each password was worth 10 points on the first clue. Now, each time the word was not guessed correctly and an additional clue was given by the other team, it was subtracted from 10. So if the first clue was 10 points, the second would go over to the other team, would be worth 9, then back over, the third would be 8th, fourth would be 7th, and then back and forth until they guessed the clue. Now the first team to get the required amount of points to win the game would move on to the bonus round. Now the bonus round varied throughout the history of the show, but to make it short and simple, it was still very similar to the main game. Contestants would still have to guess words from their celebrity partners in order to win a cash prize. They would have only a certain amount of time to do this and a certain amount of words. The more words they would guess, the more cash they would get. Now looking back at all this, it is still one of the most remembered game shows in history. Just in 2013, TV Guide ranked it as number 8 in their all-time rankings for game shows. Unfortunately, episodes of the original Password are very hard to find. Now today, I tried to find as many as I could to put in the video, but as you can see, it was a little rough. Now a few episodes of the final version of the CBS version have aired on the Game Show Network and Buzzer, because those were the episodes that were in the syndicated reruns that air across the country. But the ABC version has been almost completely lost except for a few episodes that have appeared here and there on YouTube. Now one popular rumor is that all of the ABC versions of the show were preserved, but when the Richard Dawson version of Family Feud came around, they used those same tapes to record his show. So a lot of those tapes have been re-recorded over, losing whatever was on it beforehand. But what is mostly circulated today is the revived Super Password and Password Plus. Now basically it's the same game show with some gimmicks thrown in here and there. Pretty darn similar from what you expect from the actual game show. But nothing will be like the originals that have basically been, unfortunately, lost forever. Thanks for watching another video from my channel. If you like that video, make sure to subscribe for more and ring that bell so you're notified for the next one. And now you can follow us on Twitter. So follow me on Twitter at RealTVHistory for more information on what videos are coming out. And until next time, this has been Reality TV History. See ya.